What's up, Beantown? I'm Rob Mariano. You might also remember me as Boston Rob from Survivor. And this is my town. I'll be your guide as we discover the local hotspots.
Right, my man.
Hidden gems.
This looks like a piece of art.
And some of the most unusual experiences ever.
Bone marrow lose shot.
Oh, no!
So even if you've lived here your entire life, I promise we're gonna discover something new. Let's go! What's up, guys? Today we're gonna start things off right here in South Boston, or as we call it, Southie. I used to come to Southie to enjoy the St. Patrick's Day Parade, one of Boston's liveliest celebrations every year. This neighborhood has been evolving. Today, we're gonna explore some of the hidden gems that Southie has to offer. Ready? Let's do it.
Southie has always been known for its cultural identity and a home place for many of the Bostonians with Irish-American roots. The first location on my list today is Ivy League, a place that offers a great IV treatment for those in need of some extra vitamins in their bloodstream. It's also a great treatment to a hangover. Well, we'll see about that.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you guys?
Good.
Good.
The famous Ivy League. I went out last night, had a little fun. This is the place where we get right, right?
We treat a lot of hungover people on the weekends, but a lot of it is mainly health and wellness here. Getting the high-dose vitamin C, antioxidants, good for your immune system. We get you hooked up with an IV. We're all registered nurses here.
It's a great way to just recharge and put you right back to where you left off.
So this is not like a Mickey Mouse shop. You guys are all registered nurses. We're getting the same treatment that you would get if you went to a hospital.
But better.
Is the IV the main thing you guys do here?
I do the Botox and fillers, medical aesthetics, and then we have an M-Sculpt machine too.
What's that about?
So M-Sculpt is electromagnetic stimulation. It's a body contouring device. So it's equivalent to 20,000 sit-ups or 20,000 squats in a 30-minute session.
My goodness. Yeah.
Would you like to give that a shot today?
Yeah, I mean, if I have to get hooked up to something and not actually have to do the exercise, that sounds like that's for me.
Maybe we can tighten up that rear end, huh?
listen, that's the South End, not South Boston. You and I both know that.
I had to. You know, yeah.
This is kind of crazy. I've never had anything like this outside of a hospital setting.
She was actually on the IV team for babies and things of that nature, so she's a ninja with a needle.
So what exactly is in the bag? It looks like yellow Gatorade.
You're getting the Myers cocktail today. Actually, we call it the MVP drip. So it's got magnesium, high-dose vitamin C, calcium, and a B complex in it. So everything to give you good energy, get you back to your baseline or even above your baseline.
So how long will it take before I start to feel the effects of feeling good again?
The effects are pretty immediate.
Here's the truth. I went out last night. I went to a concert. We had an early call time this morning. So I will tell you the truth, whether or not this really works. So let's talk about the butt treatment. Can I do the butt? okay. Can I get the sculpting and have the IV at the same time?
Yeah, you can actually. It's called the Kardashian treatment. You can do an IV and your butt at the same time.
Let's do it.
All right, let's do it.
Do I leave my clothes on?
You have some underwear on underneath there, I hope?
Of course.
Okay, cool.
So this is like a workout for my butt, right?
Yes, it is. Yeah, you're gonna lay on your stomach.
Okay.
And take your, okay.
Well, my boys in Boston see this.
Here we go.
I feel so uncomfortable already. You know, I've done some ridiculous things in my day.
You're gonna put a paddle on each butt.
I can apologize to my mother, my father. I'm sorry, guys.
Okay, ready?
This is.
I'm just gonna start you off slow, okay?
Yeah, please.
All right.
I feel like.
It's gonna feel like a little tickle. It's pretty cool technology.
It's something else.
Yep.
Is it electricity?
It's like punching your butt, yeah.
Yeah, I feel like electricity.
Yep.
My God. My God, am I gonna be able to walk later?
Yeah, so actually, it goes through six different cycles. One of the cycles actually takes the lactic acid out, so you're not as sore as you should be doing 20,000 squats.
What percentage of people are male versus female that have this treatment?
We get a lot of men doing their abs. You're a small percentage of men getting their butt done.
I'm special.
You are special. So, oh, that's a good one. That's a tapping motion. So this is the series that starts tapping. Yeah,
yeah, if I want a better butt, I'm just gonna have to get to the gym.
That was wonderful.
I feel sore like I've been working out. How ridiculous is this?
Good to the last drop here. How you feeling?
I feel wonderful.
Good?
I really do. I feel like
awesome.
Way better. And like I didn't go out and party all night. That's it.
That's it.
That was easy.
Thank you, guys.
You're very welcome. Enjoy the rest of your day.
Take care.
With an IV treatment giving me a boost of energy, I was in the mood for something fun. And what's more salty than candlepin bowling? The iconic Salty Bowl is located on Broadway, and it's been open for over 60 years. This staple in the community attracts both the young and old generations for some quality bowling, Boston style.
Oh, wow, check this out. This definitely brings back some memories from my childhood. This place is awesome, man. How you doing?
Good, good to see you.
How's I'm Rob.
I'm John, nice to meet you.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, no problem.
So tell me a little bit about South Boston Bowl.
It's been here for 60 years. It used to be an old car dealership. But yeah, and then the guy who owned it at the time turned it into a big bowling alley. And then my family bought it about 30 years ago, and then I got involved about 10 years ago. And we've just been kind of taking off ever since.
So do people still bowl?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, the whole neighborhood bowls, pretty much. No matter how old you are, whether you're a little kid or you're an old lady at this point.
Like, that's pretty cool.
We have 80, 89-year-old people who still bowl.
So you do see, like, younger kids coming into bowl.
I mean, people love it. It's something you can just put your phone away, go have a great day.
That's what I remember. When I was a kid, my parents would always take us here Saturday mornings, or if it was raining out, which in Boston, it rains a lot.
Yep.
And it's something that's really unique to Boston. A lot of people don't know. But candlepin bowling is from here.
Yeah.
And the biggest difference is the balls are a lot smaller. There's no holes. You get three shots instead of two. And you're not finessing it down the alley. You're whipping it down there.
Yeah, and anybody can do it too. That's the best part. I mean, no matter how old you are, everybody can candlepin bowl.
No doubt about it. Even with a broken hand, because I'm right-handed, I'm gonna give it a shot. You wanna have a game?
I do, but I'm gonna bring in my buddy John, who's one of the best around, and he's gonna kick your
Oh my God, on my own show. Well, I'm gonna do my best. Bring them on. I need some shoes, you got some?
Yeah, I definitely got a pair. What size?
Size 11, you got any?
Yeah, I got a pair for you.
All right, let's do it.
Hey Rob, this is my buddy Jonathan.
Jonathan, you come bearing gifts, my man. Been probably about 30 years since I bowled candlepin, but I feel like I'm gonna get a lesson with you here.
We'll see what I can do.
So what's your experience level here?
Oh, I've been bowling for over 20 years. I bowl in tournaments all over New England and occasionally go to Canada, won a few bucks, and yeah, it's my one little talent.
Bowling, it's always just been about having fun, so.
Yes, it is.
Let's get to it.
All right.
Cheers.
Cheers.
This place is really old school. I mean, even the score is kept with a paper and pencil. You won't find any fancy computers here.
Here we go. Seven's not bad. In school, it's a C+. You're up, brother. There's a difference from somebody that knows how to bowl. There it is, 10. My man, after one round, 11 to 19. I'm losing, but I'm not dead in the water yet. It seems so easy, but it's so hard. Ah, got it. Oops. There it is.
That's a spare.
There you go.
Oh!
Oh,
so close. Nine ball. That does it, brother. You crushed me. The final tally, 135 you, 85 me. I mean, it wasn't even close. But I have to thank you. Everybody here at South Boston Bowl, if you guys want some good, clean fun, come on down, check them out. Tell them that I sent you.
I feel like I shouldn't make plans for after this.
We only have one bottle of each, so we can
only use one bottle of each with four of us here.
Salty was always known for having some of the best pubs in town. Great places to have a beer, maybe something stronger. But today, I'll check out something more delicate. I'm talking about Love Child, a wine tasting experience right here on West Broadway in the heart of Salty.
Hey.
Hey.
How are you? I'm Rob.
Rob, I'm Crystal.
Nice to meet you.
Colleen.
Colleen, I'm excited to be here. Tell me a little bit about the shop.
Love Child is a hybrid of an event space and retail shop. Colleen's our amazing florist here, and I'm the booze behind the business. And then we host experiential events like this. We do wine tastings, different beverage events, and then also flower arranging classes.
Now, it smells amazing in here, and it looks beautiful.
We definitely are so excited to have a community space, and you know, it's a lot of young people coming in, but we've connected with a lot of the people who've lived here their whole lives, too.
Of course. Well, shall we get started?
Yeah, for sure.
All right.
I'm excited.
Well, there's cheese as well. It's a full-on wine and cheese party. If the boys at home could see me now. Welcome.
Sure.
Please join us.
How you doing?
So we're going to be tasting some wines that are from France, from Italy, from California, and from Spain.
I feel like I shouldn't make plans for after this.
We only have one bottle of each, so we can
only one bottle of each with four of us here.
Great. All right, shall we taste wine? So the first one is going to be a rosé, and it's actually going to be a more like medium-bodied rosé. So The very first thing you want to do, you want to take a look at what it is that you're going to be drinking. Can I see through it? Yes. So it's probably going to be a little bit lighter, easier to drink. So then the next step, we're going to learn how to swirl our wine. So put it sturdy and just very carefully swirl it around. We're trying to really identify what it is that we're smelling. What do you smell?
Watermelon.
Yeah.
Right?
So then now we sip, which is the most important part.
Cheers.
Thanks, guys. What do we think?
It's a little fruity for me.
Okay.
Cheers.
So, second wine. So I felt like we can get a little bit weird here. So, have you ever had an orange wine before?
Never had an orange wine.
An orange wine is white wine grapes, but they process it like red wine, so they leave the skin on there.
Thank you. And we match the flowers to the wine.
What kind of flowers are these?
That is some straw flower.
Beautiful. Tell me a little bit about the floral arrangements here.
This is what we call our bloom bar. So people come in and they make their own bouquet or we help them. So we operate like a traditional florist, and then you can come in and learn how to make an arrangement as well.
So same deal?
All right, yep, so same kind of thing. So, smells a little more earthy.
Peaches, like a peach.
Let's taste.
That's different.
Pretty cool, right?
That's something like I've never had before.
Yeah, we are gonna move over to your reds. So this one is a Pinot Nero. What do you think?
It's my favorite of the three so far.
Okay.
Just looking at this, I can tell you this is gonna be the one. Can't see through this.
Right.
Older.
So this is gonna be our Spanish reds. This wine specifically is called Black Slate. The grapes in this specific area are grown on a very slate-like mountain. What happens whenever it's difficult growing conditions, you're gonna get a more complex, more full-flavored grape. This wine is so delicious. I really
this is
like
my
this.
Favorite. It almost tastes a little bit to me like an Argentinian, like a Malbec. Yes. I feel like a little bit of the, almost like a little spice after
it is,
or something.
Yeah, a little spice like at the end.
Yeah.
What's better than learning about wine? Its origins, taste, flavor, texture, actually sipping it. The ladies from Love Child really do it right. I can't wait to come back here and try some more wine. Hey, this is all very educational. You hear me?
What we're here to do is just make hockey more accessible.
As the dusk settles over the city, I reflect back on my time as a hockey player. Yes, hockey was my life back in the day, and today I'm feeling nostalgic. I think it's time to hit the ice, but first, I gotta get some gear.
How you doing?
Good, yourself today?
I'm doing awesome, man.
Welcome to Pure Hockey.
Thanks for having me.
No problem.
I gotta get suited up, and I'm gonna play tonight.
All right, awesome. Well, come on this way.
Man, things have changed, huh, over the years?
Things have definitely changed over the years. So, we got some gear here for you.
Thank you. You know, I got a broken hand, so I might need a bigger glove.
This is our biggest one we got.
I might have to go one-handed tonight, but it'll be okay.
Oh, yeah.
How long you guys been here?
This store has been here for almost 9 years.
So this is the go-to place for hockey equipment in Boston.
100%.
Well, Boston's a hockey town, right?
Yeah, big hockey town. We love it.
From Bobby Orr to Ray Bourque to all the greats in Boston. I grew up playing this sport. I love it. I'm so happy that you're here in the neighborhood, still giving back to the community, and I thank you. Tonight, we're going to have some fun.
All right, we appreciate it. Thank you.
All right, my man. Everything fits perfect.
Wow, Rob, that looks amazing on you right
there. Ready to go. I just need a stick and a helmet, and I'll be on my way.
All right, come on over this way. Let me show you the sticks. So we got this stick right here for you.
Okay.
How does that feel right there? You ready to score some goals?
Looks good. I'm ready. I think we'll definitely score some goals with this one.
Nice.
Where are the helmets?
Have you tried that one on?
Gonna mess up my hand now. We good with that? It's good, it's too big. We gotta tighten it up a little.
100%.
What do you think, we're ready to go?
Back in the old days, hockey was played by those who aspired to pursue a career in this sport. But Salty Skating Rink offers leagues for anyone who's interested in playing and learning. The skill levels offered here are from beginner all the way up to pro. And tonight, I'm planning to see if I still got it.
Pete!
What's happening?
How you doing, man? Rob.
Excellent. Good to see you, Rob.
Thanks for having me as an honorary member of the Stinky Socks Club.
Yeah, absolutely. It's good to have you by.
Warrior Arena.
Great place.
This is where the Bruins practice.
This is it. Great facility. It's been open, I think, about 4 years now. They do an excellent job. One of the best sheets of ice in the area.
So tell me a little bit about the league. Men's league?
No, co-ed. It's 21 plus.
Okay.
What we're here to do is just make hockey more accessible.
Have fun.
Doesn't matter who you know, where you came from. If you just got to Boston, if you grew up here, you can get on the ice anytime with people that are same level as you.
That's so cool to see like hockey evolve, you know, into like an all-inclusive sport. Everybody gets on the ice, everybody gets a shot, and like that's what it's all about anyway, right? Having a good time?
Absolutely. I mean, most of the people that are behind me right here started when they were adults, and everybody out there loves to play hockey.
Yeah. And mostly it's a friendly atmosphere. Everybody's here to have a good time.
Yeah, everyone's going to work tomorrow. A lot of us, you know, we don't like going to the gym, but we love playing hockey. So
I love it.
There's never a better workout than getting out on the ice.
That's for me. I'm excited to get back out there.
I'm with you 110%.
Thanks for having me, brother.
Yeah, thank you for being here.
I've been playing hockey since I was 2 years old. I played through high school, and then I coached the inline team at Boston University. I still play hockey in a men's league to this day, and I love it. Nothing is gonna stop me from getting on that ice. Even with a broken hand, it feels great to skate around and take some shots on goal. It's wonderful to have a place like this in town that allows everyone to enjoy the sport.
There's no city like Boston, and there's no neighborhood like Southie. And as you saw here tonight, we never shy away from a challenge. We'll see you next time.